If you're a Steve Martin fan, then stick around, because you're about to discover 15 behind-the-scenes facts about the 1991 comedy drama Father of the Bride. The movie is actually a remake of another movie that was based on a book. The original Father of the Bride was released in 1950, starring Spencer Tracy and Elizabeth Taylor, and even received 3 Oscar nominations, including Best Picture. But the original idea for the story came from a book of the same name that was written in 1949. It took Steve Martin several hours to film the opening monologue. The director and co-writer Charles Shire wanted the scene to have a very relaxed feeling to it, just like the opening monologue of the 1950 film, and it took Steve Martin 35 takes to loosen up enough to get the right feel for the scene. Franck was based on a real wedding planner. Martin Short portrayed the over-the-top wedding planner Franck Egelhofer, who was partly based on the celebrity wedding planner Kevin Lee. Martin Short, who played the character to hilarious perfection, said he largely improvised Franck's dialogue, which he said was mostly just gibberish on the page anyway. As for the character's incomprehensible accent, Short admitted there was no consistency since it was a mixture of several European accents. This was Kimberly William Paisley's first movie role at 19 years old, but she wasn't the first choice for Annie. The filmmakers first wanted to cast Phoebe Cates, but she was pregnant and unavailable at the time, so they went with Kimberly instead. It took 2 houses to film the movie. The outdoor reception scenes and basketball game were filmed at a $2 million home in the Los Angeles Alhambra neighborhood, but the front of the house that we all associate with the movie was filmed in Pasadena. Steve Martin and Kimberly Williams Paisley filmed over 200 takes to get all the footage needed for the basketball scene. They filmed all night for 2 nights because the director wanted them to play for real, instead of just faking all their shots with camera tricks. Luckily, both actors were actually good ball players. Kimberly especially had a lot of basketball experience because her dad is a big fan of the sport, and played with her all the time while she was growing up. The idea for George's tuxedo scene in the attic came from the book and Steve Martin's creative input, who decided that George's pants should be too short and he should be wearing white socks. The wedding cost a lot of money. George Banks's frugality is a running joke throughout the movie, but it's never mentioned how much the wedding actually cost. BeFrugal.com broke down all the wedding expenses, and the total cost would have come to $249,323. They figured Annie's dress cost $68,000, and with 572 guests at $250 a head, George shelled out $143,000 on wedding reception food. The bridesmaid dresses tacked on an additional $10,000, and flying in 9 relatives from Copenhagen smacked George with another $10,323. The father's name was changed for the remake. The father's name from the original movie was Stanley, but the screenwriters changed it to George for the remake to have the character named after George Banks from Disney's Mary Poppins. However, they did use Stanley as George's middle name that can be heard in the jail scene. The most difficult scene for Kimberly Williams Paisley to film was the blender scene, when George goes to comfort his crying daughter after a big fight she had with her fiancé Brian. Kimberly mentioned in an interview with ABC News that she was too young in her career to be able to cry on cue, so they filmed about 50 takes hoping she would be able to shed some tears. After all that, she was still dry-eyed and had become very frustrated with herself, but they decided to do just one more take. Before the camera started to roll, she began tearing up for reals, because she felt like a complete failure. Well, those tears were eventually turned into tears of joy, because the last take worked perfectly and was reportedly the only footage used for the scene. If Annie's little brother Maddie looks familiar to you, it's because he's Kieran Culkin, who is Macaulay Culkin's younger brother, and is widely known for playing Kevin McAllister's bedwetting cousin Fuller in Home Alone, but Father of the Bride was Kieran's first major speaking role. Another actor you might know but didn't recognize is the nightclub singer, who is played by Eugene Levy. His appearance in the film was actually a reshoot, so neither of the 3 actors saw each other face to face, because the footage of Steve Martin and Diane Keaton was actually of them watching another actor sing who wasn't funny enough. So Eugene Levy was brought in later to film insert shots to make the part more funny. A wedding gift from the original movie was used in this movie too, which was the Venus clock that was found in a prop house at the Warner Brothers studio. Steve Martin agreed to do the film before it was even written. Up to this point in Steve Martin's career, he was mostly known for doing silly comedies, but by the 1990s, he was in his mid-40s, and he thought he'd look foolish if he didn't change things up and start acting his age. Just before Father of the Bride, he had done a more serious role in Parenthood, so he signed on to do Father of the Bride in the early stages of development to keep the ball rolling in this new direction of his career. Diane Keaton almost didn't get the job. When Keaton signed on to play Nina Banks in Father of the Bride, she was already familiar with the director-screenwriter Charles Shire and co-writer Nancy Myers because she had worked with them on the 1987 film Baby Boom. The problem was Disney, who owns Touchstone Pictures, didn't want anything to do with Keaton because of the last Disney Touchstone film she was in, called The Good Mother, completely bombed at the box office. So Shire and Myers practically had to beg Disney to cast her in Father of the Bride. But luckily, they gave in because she was the perfect choice for Nina Banks. If you enjoyed the video, please share it with a friend to help spread the word, and then watch another video so you can keep learning more fun facts about your favorite films.